Hey, what's up YouTube? This video is actually not that deep. Whoa, I know everybody. Calm down. I have a real life too. What? No way. Okay, this is getting kind of weird. Guess what? Your girl doesn't have an afro anymore. It's locked. So I made the decision to keep track of my lock journey because I'm learning more and more about the significance of our natural hair, which will be in a different video that I'll be doing soon and why I decided to get my hair locked. But with that being said, this video is just focusing on my 1 week lock journey so far. So right now my hair is banded into two strands. It's kind of like when I would have my loose natural hair, I would do double strand twists called a twist out. But this is just a little bit different because instead of the loose natural hair being banded together, there are two locks. But I put little rubber bands at the end because the young lady who did my hair when I was in LA, she put them in twist and I kept them in for a couple of days and I took them out and then it was all fuzzy because my loose natural hair is like, what are you doing? We're supposed to be in an afro. How could you? And then the lock natural hair was like, okay, we're gonna try this. And you know, it's just a lot of conversation going on between my hair strands. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take these out and we'll see what they look like. By the way, my stylist in LA slash friend now, shout out to you. She actually used the interlocking method. You part the hair, you take the hair strand, and you take this tool, and it brings the hairs into the middle where they hold hands and lock eventually over time. Now this process took about 8 hours for me. Mainly because we were having great conversations, so there was like a bunch of like stopping and looking at each other and joking around and laughing, as well as my hair is hecka thick. So it was a wonderful experience and I do not regret it at all. But they feel good, but again, I didn't get them for the reasons of appearance, like to look good. So I gotta get over that part, you know, cause I'm so used to like caring so much about my loose natural hair and how that looks and what the shape of the afro is because I've gone through so much with my natural hair where I finally started loving it 3 years ago. And you know, so now going into this new phase where I'm trying not to care so much about my appearance, it's hard, you know, and also being a woman, it's difficult to not care about your appearance. But I mean, like, I should care, but not to the point where it's taking control of my life, if that makes sense. But I like my locks, because they called them dread locks because the people were people of dread, because they were people of color. Had their hair like this because obviously we didn't have any combs back then. Shout out to Madam CJ Walker for, you know, inventing those. We fought against our oppressors, and so we were called the people of dread, and we were rebels against the authorities and you know, just people not treating us well. So I a rebel soul. And I'm excited for this journey. I'm excited to grow and to love my hair in the most natural state of not putting a bunch of product in it and not combing it out. I will obviously still be washing it because people with locs still wash their hair, which is a total rumor and a misunderstanding that they don't, but they do. We do. I'm part of the lock community, I guess. But if you are someone who has locks and you would love to share some of your wisdom, please comment. I would love to learn more and more about our hair and any tips you have. You know, I'm learning that it's all about the roots, it's all about your scalp. If your scalp is healthy, your hair is healthy, because all this is just dead hair, but this is where there's life. So, yep, that's my 1 week lock journey so far. I look forward to checking in. I don't know if it's going to be every week, but we're going to see. And I will not forget to make a video about why I decided to do this and the significance of our natural hair, whether loose or locked. With all that being said, have a beautiful day. I hope everyone is getting prepared for the Sabbath whenever you celebrate that. And yeah, see you later. Shalom.